Say you have a day job, want to be a full-time artist, and you have 1 hour a week to devote. Spend 50 minutes making art, 10 marketing, zero complaining. Hey, I remember the day, the moment I made the decision, I am going to write every day. All that changed is my entire life. Whenever you think you're the only one struggling to get it right, pick up a biography of any artist you admire. You'll find they all struggled.
Of the many supposed bullshit rules of screenwriting, the only one that's legit is write every day. You don't need any expert's permission to write your story your way. Repeat that. The first screenplay my partner and I wrote was rejected by every agency as unsellable. It was Rounders.
Self-doubt goes hand in hand with self-expression. Tune it out for 2 hours a day, you'll have a finished screenplay. Know this, whatever your favorite movie is, at some point during the writing of it, the screenwriter felt completely lost.
Hey, if you just can't make progress in your screenplay today, write an essay. Bang out a short story, generate some pages.
Always write for yourself, but don't be self-indulgent. Define your audience and write for them too. The realist, in a spirit of friendship, always wants to tell the writer the real odds of getting something made. Tune him out. I know writing is hard, but if you can tune out the extraneous bullshit, self-doubt, expert opinions, it's a little easier. Writers look for reasons not to write. So make a list of all the reasons you need to write and put it next to your computer. Writing a first draft can be a fragile thing. Don't sabotage yourself by talking to people who don't share your dreams. One more thing about notes, criticism. Just because they say it doesn't mean it's true. You decide what you want to believe. Take what's useful, discard the rest. It's crucial at the beginning of any creative project to know why you're doing it. That way you can remind yourself during the treacherous midpoint. If you chase a career in the arts, some people are going to think you're crazy. They're going to worry about you. But when you break through, they'll be like, I knew it all along. Think your favorite song, movie, painting. Then think about this. When the artist started, they had no guarantee that it would work. Screenwriting's not a competition, but somebody's out there not daunted by the odds, writing every day, dreaming big. Is that you? As a writer or artist of any kind, you're always bumping up against total failure. Learn to love that feeling. Learn to need it. The next time you really don't want to write, and you write anyway, circle it on your calendar. And the next time you decide not to, circle that. And look back and decide how each made you feel. I was in the bookstore earlier tonight, and I realized that every single author made a decision at some point they were a writer. Are you ready to? I promise you this, if you write every single day a year from now, you'll be a much better writer than you are today. There's not one creative endeavor I've tried that hasn't been met with resistance and rejection at first. The trick is to ignore those things. I was beating myself up about spending a Saturday reading and watching movies instead of writing. And then I remembered, input as important as output. All I want to say today is this, the romantic vision of the beautiful, tortured artist addict is a lie. Artists should cross-train for the same reason athletes do, to build different muscles. Write a song, try stand-up comedy, anything to make you stronger. When you write every day, you're not just building up discipline. You're engaging your subconscious, so it's doing work even when you're not sitting there. If rule number one is write every day, then rule number two is take creative risks. Even when they fail, you get stronger. As we head into the new year, remember, your imagination is more powerful than any critic, agent, studio boss in the world. Is it possible you won't sell that novel you're working on, or screenplay, or painting you're trying to finish? Yeah. Isn't it awesome you're doing it anyway? Professional artists don't expect to create museum-quality work with the first sketch in a new project. They just want to get something down on the canvas. Look, I get it. As often as someone tells you the Van Gogh story, rejection still stings. Fine, now go create something. But how do I know if I'm just wasting my time? How do I even know what I'm doing is any good? Nobody ever knows. Do it anyway. Think of how much joy your favorite artists have brought you. Now imagine if your work can do that for even one other person, and get to it. Hey, if you're going to become an artist of any kind, you have to know it's almost impossible to succeed, and then work like you know you will. Is writing sometimes lonely? Yes. But it's worth it for those moments when time disappears and you feel connected to everything. Nobody chooses to become a writer or any kind of an artist because it's easy. You do it because you have to. If you're trying to decide what to write, and you have one idea that scares you because you don't know what people will think of it, write that one. I find that nothing can change my state faster or get me in a creative state of mind quicker than listening to one of my favorite pieces of music. Some days you just don't feel creative. That's okay. Write anyway. At least that way, you'll build momentum. I know what that voice sometimes says. Am I just fooling myself? Should I just give up? All the artists you love found a way to press on despite it.
In the short term, it's way more comfortable to avoid the risk of doing creative work. But that short-term comfort leads to long-term pain.
Take the risk.
If making a creative leap feels like too big of a risk, think about everything you're depriving yourself of by not trying. And take that leap.
Before you quit, ask yourself this. What really matters to you? Why does it matter? And what you're prepared to do about it. Maybe you're worried that whatever you're gonna create next is gonna make someone angry. Or you're scared someone's feelings will be hurt. Do it anyway. When you're done, you can always delete it. When's the last time you took a big creative risk? Tried something you really weren't sure you could pull off? If you're an artist, you know that's when you feel alive. When's the last time you took a big creative risk? Tried something you really weren't sure you could pull off? If you're an artist, you know that's when you feel alive. Self-doubt can sound like a wise older brother telling you hard truths, but it's not. It's an evil uncle stealing the best you got.
Somewhere down deep, you know what you're meant to be doing.
What would bring out your absolute best self? Recognize it and start today. Anytime you worry you're selfish for pursuing your dream, picture the mood you'd be in every day if you weren't. Which of those people you think your loved ones would rather be around? People in your life might tell you you're wasting your time. Before you believe them, ask yourself one question. Do they really seem happy with their choices? In your quietest, most private moments, you ever feel that maybe you're not good enough? Maybe you're a fraud? So did almost every artist who ever made it. For the next 24 hours, anytime you want to complain about how hard it is to break in, think about your work instead. You can't silence your critics. Not the parent who wants you to get a real job. Not the friend who's secretly jealous. But you definitely don't have to believe them.